The Australian Embassy unveils new partnerships with local firms aimed to promoting inclusive recovery from the pandemic while also providing sustainable commercial returns for businesses. Joining us to talk more about these partnerships, we have MindU COO Cameron Quinn and Esquelab CEO Angela Chen. Angela, Cameron, good morning and welcome to the program.
Thank you so much, Ryan, for having us.
Thank you for having us.
Hi, so you've been chosen by the Business Partnerships Platform for being the top examples of inclusive businesses that are both commercial ideas but can also make a lasting social and environmental impact. How do you deliver those in your enterprises? How about we start with Angela first and then Cameron?
Sure, so Esquelabs is an online data upskilling startup, and we help people and teams learn data skills that are in demand in the digital economy. Our impact is outcome-driven, so from the placement of our students who are able to find jobs after completing our part-time programs. And we also drive down the cost of education through innovating on the product itself. So affordability and accessibility is another key dimension of the impact that we're creating.
Cameron?
Well, thank you again so much, Rain. I really do appreciate it. But with mental health challenges on the rise, the BPP partnership for MindU is extraordinarily important. It's allowed us to be able to refocus from B2B onto B2C from a demand-driven aspect. And we know to have a functioning society moving forward, we need to be able to decrease anxiety, depression, and stress in order to be able to create a productive society. So.
Right. I know that in a certain respect, you're also helping people amid the pandemic. Can you share with us how your organizations have been helping people cope with or adjust to this new situation? Cameron first, and then Angela.
So MindU built a tech solution and a business solution in order to be able to make it easier and more affordable to access mental health care here in the Philippines. So we focused predominantly on business to business over the last 18 months during this pandemic, and we've covered tens of thousands of employees. But the goal with the business platform partnership with the Australian government is specifically for us to be able to look after the greater public and the greater public's interest.
Mm-hmm. All right, Angela?
Yeah, so for us, as you may know, women have been disproportionately affected by COVID-19 due to our higher participation in service sectors like retail and hospitality, which were among the hardest hit. And even before the pandemic, female workers were underrepresented in STEM-related fields. So we were already not well-positioned to benefit from job opportunities like those in tech. And so instead of allowing these digital disruptions to leave women behind, we think that targeted upskilling will present a clear way to flip the odds. So our goal is really to improve the employability of female freelancers and their access to opportunities and higher value online work through data upskilling. Mm-hmm.
Well, Angela, your career has actually taken you through work with sustainable oceans and sustainable food and now education. You have programs that may be study now, pay later, or those with job guarantee. What is the vision for the learners and the organizations you work with? How much of your learners are actually represented by women right now?
Yeah, so I was previously working at the intersection of finance and climate change, and I really saw a key enabler was missing for more people to embrace sustainability, and it was higher incomes. When there is a higher discretionary spending power, then people can make more sustainable choices. That's how we arrived at founding an education company with a mission of democratizing opportunities in the future of work through in-demand field like data. And now we've reached the promise of higher incomes already materialized for our bootcamp learners who have increased their pay on average by 50% after completing Esquelabs.
Meanwhile, Cameron, you are the COO of MindU. You work with both SMEs and enterprises. How are they different, and who are the ideal organizations or groups to work with so that you can make the most contribution to them, the industry or the greater economy? You were saying earlier that you're moving on from B2B to B2C.
Yeah, great question, Rain, and thank you again. I haven't met anyone over the last 18 months who hasn't been negatively impacted by this pandemic, unfortunately. And what that means is, you know, every single organization that we've been working with and the trends that we're seeing within these organizations is they are getting more empathy within the organization, which is a phenomenal thing. And they're caring more about their employees and they're understanding more about how These mental health challenges actually impact their work. We're seeing higher attrition rates. We're seeing higher absenteeism, presenteeism. Presenteeism is where you are physically there but mentally absent. We are seeing some significantly skyrocketing business costs because of mental health challenges within the organization. So really, from an SME to an enterprise, SMEs have a great ability to be able to have a low-cost solution, and enterprise really do have access to economies of scale, which means it makes it way more affordable for them to actually have an employee assistance program.
All right. Being selected for the BPP gives you both new round of funding, among other rewards. May we know how much were the grants for your enterprises, and what expansion possibilities will this afford for you? How about we start with Angela this time?
Sure. So our initiative is called the Democratizing the Future of Work through Data Upskilling Initiative. And that's a partnership between us, Escolabs, FH Moms, the largest entrepreneurship and freelancing network in the Philippines for female freelancers, and the Australian government. And so the total funding for the project is about 9 million pesos, with half of that being funded by the Australian government and the other partners spotting the rest. And so for us, the partnership aims to help 10,000 female freelancers who typically undertake administrative jobs to move towards higher value work through improved data and analytics skills. Mm-hmm. And we hope to achieve that through a new product we're launching, which is a free mobile-based upskilling course.
All right, Cameron.
Absolutely. So through the business partnership platform with the Australian government, we are going ahead and moving towards a 39 million peso program in order to be able to create the most effective mental health solutions for the Philippines market. In order to do that, they are contributing 18 million peso. So the Australian government is contributing 18 million peso to this program, which we are incredibly grateful for from the Australian government. And where it's going towards is three different pillars. The first pillar is to help with the destigmatization of mental health. So that takes education and awareness. The second pillar is to be able to increase the affordability of mental health services. So we are using our business-to-business model to be able to take a lot of the underlying fixed costs of the organization to further reduce the cost so we can give more Filipinos access to mental health. And the third is to increase accessibility. So that's where the online platform comes from.
Mm. Apart from the, will there be other support provided for both of you, both your organizations under BPP? And will there be some form of monitoring for the results and whether you've achieved your target over that time period? Cameron.
Absolutely. So this is a three-year program with the Australian government. We have very specific reporting mechanisms for us to be able to work with the Australian government and the Australian embassy here in the Philippines. They have been absolutely phenomenal with more than just monetary support, with introductions to the right stakeholders in the country. One of the other pillars for the actual grants is for us to assist the country with increasing the number of professionals. Unfortunately, there is a limited number of clinical psychologists in the country to actually facilitate all of the clinical sessions, and the demand is significantly increasing. So we want to be directly responsible for increasing the number of registered and licensed psychologists by 10% in the country through what we're calling a world-class internship program, where we already have partners, and we've already had over 150 interns come through from basically every single major university in the country. And so the Australian government has definitely supported that with a lot of significant introductions to the right people to be able to make things happen quickly, because we do have urgency around this. We are seeing significant increases in suicide-related calls. So there was over 1,000% increase in suicide-related calls from quarter one 2020 to quarter one 2021, sorry. And we do have some urgency around our solutions and what we're bringing to the market.
There's certainly some urgency there. Angela, other support from BPP other than funding?
Yes, for sure. So our partnership, as I mentioned, aims to help at least 10,000 female freelancers. And we will be marketing this course to FH Moms Network of over 300,000 members. And while the product is free, it will operate on a sustainable basis via the conversion of learners into pay programs at Esclabs. And that's definitely something we'll be monitoring. And from the Australian government, of course, they're providing the catalytical funding. Without that, we would not have been able to put the partnership together at this scale. But they're also providing gender expertise, which is particularly important for our project, as well as the connection to an extensive network of Australian businesses that our learners can benefit from.
Mm-hmm. All right, ultimately, what does being selected for BPP mean for you both? What initiatives would you like to see more support for as this pandemic continues? And what is the ultimate goal for our people? You are here in the Philippines. Angela first.
So for S-Clubs as a company, we're impact venture, and we envision that the digital economy that's now been accelerated by COVID as something that is data-driven and include women, but not just as consumers of digital products and data points, but also as creators and collaborators themselves. And so the value-based approach of the Australian government really has aligned with our mission and the FH Moms community, and that's something that we're super excited about.
All right, Cameron.
So I think as Angela said so well, it is a catalytical investment to ensure that we can actually go into this market. Through the BPP, ultimately, we're probably 12 to 18, maybe even 24 months ahead of where we actually would have otherwise been, which is a real significant pressure on our organization, because we do have people digitally knocking on the door basically on a daily basis now asking for assistance and help. Through the BPP grants with the Australian government, we are looking to achieve at year five over 124,000 sessions per year. And the ultimate goal is to be able to do 74,000 one-hour clinical psychology sessions for free per year by year five. And MindU has a mission to be able to help a million Filipinos overcome stress, anxiety, and depression by 2025.
Lots of assistance there, translating for the Filipino people. Thank you so much for the work that you do. MindU COO Cameron Quinn and Esquelab CEO Angela Chen, congratulations on the BPP recognition, and we hope to see more of you in the coming days. Thank you for coming on this show.
Thank you so much, Rain.